Well, annuals are one of those plants that provide that huge splash of color all summer long. I'm with Diane from Wavre Farms down in Salem. And Diane, what do you have for us today?
Well, I have an exciting new geranium from the Americana line. Americana has not come out with a new geranium in several years. So we have our Rose Ice here and our Violet Ice. So they bring out a little bit of that white texture. They almost look like they're painted.
It is. And the bloom size looks gigantic.
They are. They're fairly large geraniums. And so these ones, because they are the Americanas, they're going to go about 16 inches tall. So they're going to take up some nice space in the landscape or fill up a very large pot.
Ah, and then it looks like you have a little Kufia there also, I'd write.
I sure do. This is one of our favorites. This is Vermillionaire, and it is a great hummingbird magnet. This little plant is going to go full sun, and he is super easy, no deadheading required. Plant him in a nice sunny pot and watch those hummingbirds come.
But they like that long tubular flower to get their beak into, don't they?
They sure do. So that's a great way to attract some hummingbirds to your yard this spring.
And then you have a little impatient sitting right there too, right?
I sure do. So this is one of my favorites. This is a sun impatient. And the fabulous thing about impatiens is they're usually for shade. But this little beauty will go full sun. It will also take a part day of shade. So if your front yard is kind of one of those sticky situations where you really want the same color throughout, you can pair this throughout your yard and it will do very well.
Excellent. And then you have a couple others down in there, it looks like, for some like Broelias, those blue and white.
I do. I have some little Broelias down here. And you know, it's so hard to find some great color for shade if you don't want to do impatience. So these little Broelias, they are these great little star-shaped flowers. The white does get a little taller than the blue, so it's really easy to put the blue in front in your flower bed. And then if you decide that you want to pair it with like a great coleus in the back, it gives you some nice color because this coleus will take part shade. A lot of our coleuses now will go sun or shade, but this one does like a little bit of shade in the afternoon.
And just that, you know, that huge bold color, you know, it really makes a statement in a planter.
It sure does. I mean, just a little couple little things like that really makes a nice little planting.
Right. And then what's that little yellow blooming one behind you?
Oh, this little yellow guy hiding back here. He is one of our favorites as well. This is a little straw flower. This little straw flower is going to go about 16 inches tall. He does like a lot of water. It's one of those. I joke with people saying plant him by a hose. Because dry flower does not mean dry plant. He does get thirsty.
Right. And then it looks like you have one more choice of a coleus there. A yellow one?
I do. This is a very fun chartreuse coleus called River Walk. And the fascinating thing about this coleus is it will go full sun or it will go full shade. So it's another one of those that can go pretty much anywhere in your yard.
Well, that's great. So you know, aside from all of the wonderful annuals that you have, and the splash of color, you also do vegetables too, right?
We do. This year we went above and beyond to find as many vegetables as we could to help people with their victory gardens. So we have about 32 different varieties of tomatoes. Wow. We have lots of different peppers in different sizes and lots of the garden veggies, the cold crop veggies, and pretty much everything.
And then what are your hours that you're offering now with all the Corona going on?
So with the Corona going on, we are open Monday through Saturday, 9 to 6. Sundays, 11 to 4, as always. However, we are taking some additional steps. Every cart is bleached down with a sprayer with bleach water solution running through it. And all of the pin pads are bleached down. We are asking customers to keep their 6-foot social distancing. We are pretty much out here in the middle of nowhere. My nursery sits in the middle of a big, huge farm. So there's lots of space for social distancing. And it's a great way for people to get out, see some color, and enjoy the beauty of the outdoors.
Well, that's great. So if you want a great selection of your annual colors, your vegetables, and everything else, you can go to your website, or you can go to gardentime.tv, and we'll click you over. So, you know, Diane, it's been a pleasure, and we'll see you in the garden.
Thank you so much.